Division. X squared plus 5x plus 7 divided by x plus 2. Then always check the left-hand side first. Only left-hand sides. Okay? Now, x squared divided by x. Oh, obviously, just x. Then x times x is x squared. Now, x times 2. Oh, that's it. So 2x, right? Okay. Now, you subtract. Oh. So now, x squared minus x squared is gone. Now, 5x minus 2x is 3x. So you know that. Very simple. Now, plus 7. Now, check the left-hand side again. Say x and 3x. That means this is going to be 3. Now, you just multiply 3 times x. That's going to be 3x. Now, 3 times 2. Oh, that's going to be positive 6, right? Now, you subtract again. Now, this is going to be gone. Now, 7 minus 6, which is 1. Oh, 1 is the remainder. So, actually, you can say or maybe 1. Okay, something like that. Or you can add this one right here. It's the positive 1. Okay, 1 over. Then x plus 2. See? So, that's it. Okay, let's try this one again. Okay, just to check the left-hand side. See? Okay, x and x squared must be x right there. Then x times x is x squared. Now times, that's going to be positive 5x. Now you subtract. So simple. See, now 2x minus 5x, that's negative 3x. That's it. Now you borrow this one right there. Okay, then, oh, you just check the left-hand side. Again, left-hand side. See? Okay, that means this is going to be negative 3, because negative 3 times x is negative 3x anyway. So now, negative 3 times positive 5, oh, that's negative 15. Oh, now we subtract this one, just like this. Then, oh, this is going to be gone. Okay, now what about negative 9 minus minus 15? Okay, negative negative means a plus, right? That means plus 15 minus 9, this is going to be 6. That's right. That is going to be the remainder. Now, all remainder is positive, so you can write plus sign. Maybe you can add this one. Okay, 6 over x plus 5. That's it. So you use this whole thing right there. Yup. Okay, let's try this one. X squared divided by x is x, obviously. Okay, then, oh, x times x is x squared. Then, 3 times x is positive 3x. That's right. Now, subtract, right? Okay, that means negative 3 minus 3x, which is a minus, right? Okay, negative negative, so it's going to be negative 6x. So, you need some practice for this one, okay? So now, okay, oh, the left-hand side again. Okay, so divide by negative 6 divide x, which is negative 6, right? Then negative 6 times x is negative 6x. Negative 6 times 3 is negative 18. Oh, now you subtract, right? Subtract means minus, okay? So that means a minus minus means plus. That's why 18 is going to be positive. Now minus 7, which is 11. Oh, that's it. So now plus 11 over x plus 3. That's it. Okay? Okay, now I'm going to show you the mechanical division, or they call synthetic division, whatever. Then this time, so we're going to use just the numeric coefficient, not x, okay? That means x squared, that means just one front of it, right? That means a 1 right there. Next one is a negative 3. See, just like that. Next one is a negative 7. See? Oh, so simple. Now you just make sure to give one room right there. See? Okay, enough room to write something. Okay, so now, oh, a box, little box. You don't have to. Then, opposite of positive 3, which is negative 3. Oh, yes. Okay, just like that. Then, the first one. Okay, let's do it. Let's add this way, okay? Vertically, we add, okay? 1 plus nothing, that means 1. Oh, now times this way, okay? Times negative 3 times 1 is negative 3. Now you add, okay, this time vertically, you add, okay? That means negative 6. Okay, Now, oh, negative 3 times negative 6, which is a positive 18. Oh, 18 right there. Now you add, okay? So always vertically, we add, okay? Add vertically. Remember this picture. Okay, that means 18 minus 7, that's 11. That's it. Oh, that's the remainder. Oh, the same remainder right there, see, 11. Also, okay, so this one is the quotient right there. Okay, the first left-hand side, this is going to be x. 1x means x. Okay, that means x minus 6. Oh, yes, x minus 6 right there. See? Okay, let's try this one. Long way first, okay? Long division. Okay, so x and x squared. Oh, it must be x, right? X times x is x squared. Now, x times negative 2 is negative 2x. Now, you subtract. Oh, yes. Okay, now, okay, negative 10x minus minus 2x means plus 2x. That's why negative 8x. Now, minus 3. Now, oh, the left-hand side again. Negative 8, right? So, negative 8. Now, negative 8 times x is negative 8x. Now, negative 8 times negative 2 is a positive. That's right. Positive 16. Now you subtract. Oh, just like this one. Then this is going to be gone. Now, minus 3 minus 16. That means, oh, both negative. So negative 19. Okay, that's it. That's the remainder. So remainder is negative. Okay, so minus 19 over, okay, x minus 2. See, that's it. That is the total answer right there. Okay, this time, let's use synthetic division. That's right. See, just like that. So, enough room for two lines, right? Okay. The coefficient for x squared was 1. That's it. Very simple. So, 1. Now, next one is negative 10. So, negative 10. Next one is negative 3. Oh, that's all you need. Okay, then left-hand side, you can make a box. Okay. Now, opposite of this one. See, opposite. That means minus 2, now 2, right there. Then, the first one, you 1 plus nothing, that's 1. Okay, now you multiply. 2 times 1 is 2. Then you add, okay, negative 8. Now you multiply this way, okay, 2 times negative 8, which is negative 16. Now you add vertically, right? Okay, negative 3, negative 16, which is negative 19. Wow, that's going to be the remainder. Yes, remainder is on the top right there. Then x minus 8. Oh, right there. Look at this one. This one is x minus 8. Right there. See? Everything front of your eyes. Okay, this time let's try this one then. Uh-huh. Okay, x cubed divided by x. That means x squared going to be right there on the top, right? Okay, so x squared. X squared times x is x cubed. See? Now, x squared times 3, that's right. Okay, 3x squared. Now you subtract. Ooh, just like that. That means, oh, 2 minus 3, that means negative 1. Oh, okay, negative just x squared. That's enough. Okay, now you borrow this one. Okay, now, oh, divide by x from negative x squared, right? Oh, must be negative x. Negative x times x is negative x squared. Now, negative x times 3 is negative 3x. Oh, now you subtract. Okay, now, oh, this is going to be gone. Now, 5 minus minus 3, that means 8x. That's it. Now, you add this one. Okay, now the left-hand side again. So, 8x divided by x is positive 8. That's it. Okay, now 8x. Now, 8 times 3 is 24, right? Oh, that's it, 24. Now, you subtract, that's going to be negative 21. That's it. So, the answer is minus 21 over, okay, x plus 3. That's it. See? The remainder right there, negative 21. Now, this time I'm going to use synthetic division. Okay, numeric coefficient, the first one, x cube, front to that one, 1. Oh, next one is 2. Next one is 5. Next one is 3. Oh man, no negative. So simple. Okay, then you can make a little box right there. What is the opposite of 3? negative 3. That's it, the first one, 1 plus nothing is 1. Then 1 times negative 3 is negative 3. You add this one, negative 1. Okay, you multiply negative 3 times negative 1 is the 3. You add, that's 8. 8 times this one is negative 24. Now, oh, you add this 2, it's going to be negative 21. Oh, that's going to be left over, which is the remainder. Okay, so now, first one right here, oh, plus 8. Next one, minus 1x, which is x. Oh, the left-hand side is going to be x squared. Now, this is going to be minus. That's why minus, oh, 21 over x plus 2. See, x plus 3, I mean. Okay, very simple. Look at that. The same answer.